Just on a side note here, on a side note. If this is the position vector, this is your position vector, the blue one. Can you tell me how you're going to get r dot, please? What's r dot?
How are you going to differentiate the velocity?
What's that?
If your position is function of some q, x and theta, how are you going to get your velocity? Come on, guys.
Yeah, so it's chain rule, partial r, partial q, times q dot, right? Each one of these, so we're going to have here j, and summation over j. So you can see that this guy is actually here, right? So in your expression for the velocity, whatever multiplying x dot is that term for the x equation. Whatever multiplying theta dot is that term for the theta equation. We call this actually velocity coefficient. So your velocity is always linear in the dot thing, in the q dots. This is your velocity is linear in x dot. This is your velocity is linear in x dot, linear in theta dot, right? Just something times x dot, something times theta dot. It's always like this. And this something, the coefficient, is that coefficient that we're talking about. Okay? This is what we call velocity coefficient. So you can write it like this, partial ri, partial qj, or from this picture, it's simply partial ri dot, partial qj dot. This is why we call it velocity coefficient, okay? Instead of differentiating the position, differentiating the velocity because it's easier. Because it's not actually differentiation, it's simply taking the coefficient of the velocity. We're gonna do it now. I'm just claiming that this red equation is a bit easier than before. We're gonna do it, okay? Question, please? Any question? So like I said, partial ri partial qj turns out to be partial ri dot partial qj dot, okay? And since now we are making the dot product with the velocity, we're gonna just name this principle of virtual power. It's power not work now because we're multiplying by velocity, not displacement. No. It's just a name for it, principle of virtual power. Okay? And it's pretty common. I like it. If I'm not going to use the Lagrange's equation for some reason, I'm going to do it this way. So let's solve our same problem using this red big equation. Okay? Let's do it. What are the ingredients? Forces, accelerations, yes, I do have them. Here are the accelerations, the forces. I need the velocity coefficients now. I need the velocity coefficients. So let's do it. So I need partial r1 dot, partial x dot. Right? And partial r1 dot, partial theta dot, and I need partial r2 dot,
partial x dot and partial r2 dot partial theta dot, your velocity coefficients. Okay? Right? I have two masses and I have 2 degrees of freedom. Each mass has a position vector and a velocity vector, which is called r dot. You're going to differentiate this r dot with respect to all the q dots. Q1 dot, q2 dot, and so on and so forth. My q's are simply x and theta. I'm going to differentiate it with respect to x dot and theta dot. So here is your velocity, r1 dot. Please differentiate it with respect to x dot. What do you get? What do you get if you differentiate this with respect to x dot?
I.
Simply r, right? Yeah, these are vectors. So I get here r. And if you differentiate with respect to theta dot, what do you get?
Zero.
I get zero. So this means that this particle is not affected by this degree of freedom. And the same for